What's up, Jaywalkers? We are going to be watching the season one finale, finally, for Charmed. And yeah, the last episode was a Leo Piper paradise. We had so many amazing scenes with him. And then at the end, of course, Piper asked him if they can be together, if he would quit being a white lighter for her, just for them to be in love together. And you know what needs to happen. But then Leo, I mean, that's his life. White lighter, that's who he is. So not being able to do that anymore, it honestly sucks. So Leo says he should go after that. Tells Piper he loves her. Doesn't give her time to respond. Boom, Leo's gone. Heart is broken. But it was a great episode for them too, and just seeing Leo back like that, and that way, seeing him in pain and then Piper being there for him, the switching powers, there were so many great things to love from the last episode, and it even ended on a very, wholesome moment. We had that fucking detective dude turn into a straight-up demon on Andy. So much happened last episode. It was a good one. It really was. But we are finally to this finale. I can't wait to watch it and then jump into season two. Yeah, just some very exciting stuff. The full reaction to this episode, not other episodes I watched for Charmed, are up on my Patreon page. Link to that will be in the description box of this video, not other videos here on YouTube. So if you want to check out the full uncut and edited reactions, feel free to hit that link and do so. But if we're on YouTube, just please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And with that being said, we're going to jump into it. Let's go. This guy. Leave the sisters alone.
I have been sent to you, Rodriguez.
Whoever sent you needs to send you the hell back.
I can defeat the charmed ones on my own. I don't need any.
Good luck!
Watch your tongue, Rodriguez, lest I split it for you. It's one thing to have
would
found
love to see
the charmed ones. It's quite another to defeat them together in one place by midnight and give it your best shot. I'll be there to help you learn by your failures. Trust me. How do you expect to get them together? Trudeau.
San Francisco, well, it looks like it's going to be a beautiful Wednesday in the Bay.
But what are you doing at Quake? It's 8 o'clock in the morning.
We'll see if that's true. I don't know.
Where did you park my car last night? In the driveway? I think. Mrs. Henderson's car. Oh, thank God. I mean, that your car's in the driveway and
it's
I'm
not
in the doghouse.
Still not good.
They think that he killed that internal affairs car?
Andy doesn't
no
deserve
way.
Any of this. Everything that has happened to Andy throughout this whole season. Has he deserved it? No. Oh my God!
Andy, Prue.
It looks like we got some work to do to make sure that does not happen.
Positive that it was Andy.
Gosh.
I just want to be sure.
Unless Andy has
this
a twin we don't know about.
Talking, you know,
it was Andy the man.
And it was too risky for you to be seen with him. Yeah, well, I don't
this
care.
Is,
let
this is bigger than all that. This is death.
Led my partner Rodriguez something you would know anything about.
Ooh.
The record? I'm not saying anything without
make
my
yourself comfy.
Come on. I know all about those unsolved cases of yours. And I know who's behind them too. Care about her very much to give up your career for her. Prue Hollowell is a witch.
He'd give up his life for her too.
Wait here. I'll go warn the Western Fox. I don't have time to screw around, Trudeau. I want you to arrange me. Find who killed my partner. I'll drop on charges. Don't tell anybody about her.
That was Andy's best line. I'm good.
Just called Cindy to see you too.
Oh man, that was the greatest line I've ever heard.
But you have to get all three of them together. Trudeau cares about her. He won't let her risk meeting me alone.
I had a premonition of Andy dying. What? What? This morning?
I'll just ruin anyone's day.
One time, we have to figure out who's a demon.
Piper?
There she is.
It's Joanne! Joanne Hertz, Baker High, class of 92. What are you doing here? I'm the segment producer. Wow, what a small world. I thought you moved to New York.
It's pretty crazy.
Enough about me. What have you been doing?
working her butt off.
We just have to be extra careful until we figure out who this demon is.
What if the demon is Rodriguez?
Why would you say that?
X's partner was killed by a supernatural being somehow.
Andy is a great detective.
How would he know that unless...
Unless he's a demon.
I don't have a choice. If I don't meet with
tell Rodriguez to bring his best.
I can't do that.
They kill Andy off in this episode. That's gonna hurt. I can't watch it.
I still care for you.
Good cat.
I don't know why I'm the one answering the door, because you're the one who knows martial arts, alright? That way if Rodriguez shows up and tries something right off the bat, you can knock him down.
Yeah, there we go.
What time is it?
Skills ready. Get your skills ready, Phoebe. Oh, shit. Oh! He did really come in here starting shit, didn't he? Oh. Wait. Is that, does that set that early? Phoebe. Oh my god. What? Hold on, she did not die from that. No way.
Time has been reset, or rather, I have reset time. Wednesday morning, all over again.
This
is why.
This is some bullshit.
You will learn more.
This is some bull. Once again, shit. Oh my god! Every time we kill this dude, boom! There he is again. Oh shit!
Whoa.
Deja vu. Have you seen this before?
I want to make sure I'm awake because if I am, having one killer deja vu happened before everything. I'm talking about the paper. Did you see the front page? See? Like that.
Man, these fucking demons shouldn't be allowed to do this. Turn back time? That's cheating.
Forget your lawyer, Trudeau. I'm not screwing around this time. This time? What are you talking about?
He's gonna ruin things for himself.
I know my partner was killed by a supernatural being. Just get the commissioner to signal Batman and then I'll get right on it. I think I'm joking. I know that.
I want them to keep going back in time to this very moment so Andy can say the greatest line ever again.
So they anticipate where she's coming from early before she has a chance to...
Yep, that's cheating. It's gonna go very badly again.
Even worse,
and again. And again, and eventually Phoebe's gonna figure this out.
Joanne here is the Food Network segment producer. She's about to brag how she's happily married to some rich guy. But this is all gonna make you feel like you're wasting your life away in comparison.
What if he is a demon and it turns out to be a trap?
The off-pipeline TV there to back me up, the power of three. This seems a little familiar to me, that's all. Kind of like
okay, it's coming back to her, too.
You can't be at the meeting. In Phoebe's premonition, that's where you were when I'm going to use my magic on you. You know how much I still love you.
Round two. Let's see how it goes. Oh, he came in. He came in ready. He came in so ready this time. Oh! And... turn it back! Round three.
Third time is the charm.
Third time, you better worry about Andy.
San Francisco, well, it looks like it's going to be a beautiful Wednesday in the Bay Area.
It's never a beautiful Wednesday.
Okay, we've got major demon hunting to do. Oh, and if you run into someone named Joanne from high school, just tell her to go stick it. I will explain later. One, car honks, skids, crashes. The day keeps repeating itself. I know it. And every time it happens, I think I figure it out just a little bit faster. If I touch that paper, I will have a premonition, the same one that I've had before, where Andy gets killed. Well, I've got to dig through the book of shadows, find a way to vanquish this time demon before him.
There's no more time loops.
Let's see about that.
Two first, and then the other two.
Too cocky.
Which is powerful, as you said, he's got to be after now.
Andy, please just let us
Andy,
know
once again.
Whatever you do, you have to promise me.
Being great.
What if that's what he wants, all three of you together? What if that's the reason he set the time?
We'll just have to take our chances.
You could get killed for any of you.
And come on, we gotta defeat this guy. I would love to see that again and again and again and whatever, but let's wrap it up, guys. Oh, shit. Yeah. Yeah, we saw that. Oh, God. Things are gonna be a lot different this time. Oh! Oh, okay, okay. Yeah, you didn't get anyone right off the bat this time. Okay.
He's dead.
And they can't stay
dead. The only reason you're still alive is because I haven't figured out how to kill you yet. Andy's dead. You can't save him, Phoebe. No? We're in a time loop, aren't we?
All we have to do
is start this day over. I'm willing to bet that his death somehow triggers the time loop. So where do we find him?
In the nightmares.
Probably right about that.
If that's exactly his plan, to reset the day, and he can kill us all next.
Let's not wake up, Rue. I don't think she wants to see any of this.
Andy?
What's going on?
Where are we?
Deja vows that I'm staying. You're not. I broke my promise, Prue. I came to your house tonight. Turns out Phoebe's premonition was what couldn't stop after all. It's okay, Prue. Really. Trust me.
No.
Everything happens for a reason. Remember, you taught me that. You need to go back.
We can't do this, Andy.
Being reset again, or you and your sisters will be killed.
You know what? Just untie him. Get him out of here.
What?
He'll kill us. I will not untie him, bro.
Well, he's untied. Gonna let this bastard get away. That was stupid on your part.
We may not be murderers, but
no, Andy.
We're angels either.
No, Andy. It doesn't feel real. It's right in front of me, and it doesn't feel real. I never thought I'd see this day.
Francisco. Well, it looks like it's going to be a gorgeous Monday morning here in the Bay.
I've decided to quit my job.
What?
And actually, I owe it all to Joanne. She made me realize that somehow I had forgotten what my dreams were. It's okay, but it's not my dream job.
Well, I'm proud of you.
I think that's great.
So proud.
Really.
Andy's been exonerated. They're now looking for Rodriguez.
Good luck.
We do good things together. Helps offset the bad things.
It's going to be very sad without him.
It's not gonna feel right.
Something tells me that he'll always be with us.
That was like the best way you could end the episode and the season off on. Goodbye. Goodbye, Andy. Well, there we have it, guys. The season one finale of Charmed. There's so much to say and to talk about with this episode, and the only thing on my mind is Andy's death. Did not see them going in that direction. Did not think we'd lose Andy this early. There was something in me that felt like Andy would always be here, and he's always going to be with them in spirit. Whatever, yeah. But actually losing Andy in this show, it hurts. It does. He was one of my favorite characters. Loved watching everything he did with Prue and his detective work, and you know, him being confused and not knowing what was going on the majority of the season, and finally figuring it out, finally getting help from Prue with these cases, and then we lose him. We did get to see Prue say, "I love you." We got to see it a few times. We got to see some very good moments between them two, but just knowing Andy won't be here alive anymore, I can't get over that. It hurts a lot, but he died a hero. He died after seeing those evil-ass red eyes on Rodriguez, ran in there, tried to save them all, and got blasted into a new dimension, and we lost them. And we also had to see Piper die this episode. Thank goodness we could turn that back. We got to see Phoebe die a few times. Turn that back, thank goodness. But Phoebe was the first one, really, knowing this was like deja vu. This happened before, and then after it happened again. But she was saying everything that happened, and then, you know, Piper and Prue kind of joined along after that. But this is crazy. This is a great finale. Everything about it was great. It was a good episode. Very emotional. But yeah, Charmed as season one. It was a blast. It was a blast. We've had some emotional moments. We've had some funny moments. Andy in this episode, I died every time. But yes, just everything you could ask for in a TV show. Funniness. Emotional scenes. Sweet sister scenes, serious scenes, cheesiness. The show has had a lot of cheesiness, which I have enjoyed. I mean, it's a 90s show. The cheesiness is what makes this show. It's part of what makes the show. But yeah, season one was definitely a roller coaster ride, and a lot of fun to watch. Piper, still at the end here, I would say is my favorite sister. Piper, I feel like Phoebe is kind of a close... Phoebe and Prue were kind of close seconds. Nothing felt real after Andy died. Like, I'm talking about this, but, like, did I actually just watch that? Like, what? Oh, not Andy. Not Andy. Oh, we didn't get to see Leo in this one, which hurt a little bit. I need to see Leo some more, but... It was a really good season one, and we're finally gonna move on to season two. And like, these last few episodes of Charmed have just, I felt like they've been on a new level, like in terms of everything, really. It just seemed like just a much better show than it was at the start. Started was good, it was good too, but I mean, it continued to get better, and hopefully they can carry that into season two and so forth. But yeah, guys. Andy died. Like, I can't get over it. Hope you guys enjoyed my reactions to all of season one. I'll see you for season two. Thank you all for watching. I'm out.